This is a 2008 Toyota RAV4 with a 2GR-FE engine. This is a Toyota Camry 2007 with a 2GR-FE engine. And this is a 1993 Toyota MR2 with a 2GR-FE engine. This video is intended for people who do a 2GR-FE swap into the SW20. And what I want to point out and compare is the location of the engine grounds, the engine ground wires on these cars. And this is something that sometimes is overlooked or neglected, and this can cause several issues like device trouble codes or check engine light that cannot be tracked down, and possibly even runnability issues. The 2GR-FE engine grounds to the frame in two spots on top of the valve covers. This is one spot right here. This wire goes from the valve cover to the frame. And the second spot is back here. Down here, this wire, okay, goes from the valve cover back to the frame. And these both attach at a point near the strut tower. This is true in the RAV4. Let's go look at the Camry. So we're looking at the Camry. The Camry harness is a little bit different from the RAV4 harness. In the RAV4, the engine computer is in the front by the battery. And in the Camry, the engine computer is on the firewall behind the engine. But the two grounding points are exactly the same. This is one grounding point right here. And the second grounding point is, well, you can't see it. You're gonna have to take my word for it that it is right back there on the valve cover, just behind and underneath the attachment point for the VVTI line. And both of these wires, this wire and this wire, come from the valve covers, and they attach to this metal bracket on top of the strut tower. So basically, it's despite the differences in the engine harness, the grounding points are exactly the same. One important difference between the RAV4 harness and the Camry harness, this is the Camry harness right here, it has this computer or sensor ground bundle that attaches right here on the front valve cover. And if we go look on the RAV4, the RAV4 does not have a ground wire in this position. So that's the difference between the two harnesses, that the RAV4 uses a sensor ground or ECU ground in a different engine harness ground in a different spot. Now, where this might this be? I don't want to take this plenum off the car right now, but I suspect that on the RAV4, if I recall correctly, I may be wrong about this because I'm an old man and my memory is going, but there may very well be that the ECU ground with the RAV4 harness is underneath the plenum on the valve cover. So now let's look at my MR2 with the 2GR engine. And you can see that I've attached this ground wire right here, just the same as you have in the Camry and the RAV4. And the second ground wire is, you can see that shiny bolt head. That's the bolt that holds the wire down to the valve cover. And where I have attached these is, you can't see, it's in the bottom of the frame. It's right in front of the strut tower. There's a mounting point for engine ground original in the SW20. So I've used that point, and these wires just go back there. So now we're on the flywheel side of the engine, and I want to point out the important harness grounds that are on this side. The first one is down in the bottom right here. I got all kinds of stuff in the way, of course. But you can see this weird plastic thing is no, that's the connector for the AFR sensor. But this down here, okay, this is an attachment point for the engine harness grounds, and it attaches on the side of the head down under there, and there's an additional ground wire that attaches in the same spot. Okay, so under directly underneath the throttle body. The other grounding point for the engine harness is on the front head, and it comes off the engine harness right here, and it goes to a boss that's on the side of the head down underneath here where I'm pointing. I can't see it very clearly, but it's there. Believe me, it's there, okay? The other ground point that deserves mention is the ground point for the starter, and it comes from the top of the transmission, so looking down from the throttle body, straight down, go to the top of the transmission, you see this bolt right here, this bolt, and it has a big fat wire coming off of it, because the transmission needs a big fat ground, I mean the starter needs a big fat ground, and this wire goes to an attachment point right there by the motor mount. Okay, and this is what allows the starter to ground and power the starter motor. Okay, so that covers it. I hope you find this video useful, and do pay attention to those harness grounds and those engine grounds. They are very important. And if you're missing them, if they're faulty wire or faulty attachment for the ground, then it may be the cause of a lot of problems with check engine light, with runnability problems, misfires, and false sensor readings, and so on.